Well, hello and welcome to yet another Tuesday Teaching Tips. Sometimes you have to say, where do the weeks go to? So, if you're in England or any other part of the world where you're teaching online, and in England we've just all had to go back into a second lockdown and so everybody will be online again. And if your heart was sinking at the thought of going and teaching online, then despair not, because I've got a little activity for you today that you can do with beginners who are just moving on to reading from the stave. Now, I've got a couple of beginners who are doing this at the moment, and that's really had to get my brain thinking about how you do that when you're doing an online lesson, because I haven't stopped all the way from September. I've continued to do online, so I've been having to think very hard each week about new creative activities. Normally when I'm introducing the stave, I'll go onto the floor and I'll use a floor stave, because we know that spacing the learning activity, doing it in different places as well, and moving away from just the keyboard can really, really help with the learning. But that's another whole Tuesday Teaching Tips. So I'm working, as I say, on how I teach the stave and landmark notes and things. But one particular strategy I've been using very successfully is to use the hand stave. Now, this is a very Kodai type thing, but it works brilliantly, because of course, what have we got? We've got five fingers, and of course we have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we've got the spaces, or the gaps actually, as one of my little students likes to call it, there. But I didn't feel that that was a particularly exciting thing to do, just to put your hand up like that in the middle of a lesson, you can do. So I happened to see that we had quite a big box of these things, those blue disposable gloves. So I've taken one and I've drawn on it with an indelible, is that the right word? Indelible pen. So now, can you see it? Let's just come back here. I'm hoping you can see it. It's a bit of a glare coming from the light here. So now we've got lines across. 1, 2, and then they can see the lines and they can see the spaces. And now we can talk about the second line or the third line. And because I think it's on a glove, there is no confusion about finger numbers on the piano, yeah, which was always the problem when you get to this. Now there's no confusion because it's a completely different thing. It's nothing like your piano hand because you've got a blue glove on it. So we've been doing lots of work on establishing, let's say, in the treble clef, in the G clef, you know, here's a note. So if we take a song like Apple Tree, Apple Tree, and it's really important to have something fun to point with as well. So this is my pirate pencil. Pirate pencil meet blue glove meet hand stave. Off I go, Apple Tree, will your apple fall on me? I won't scream, I won't shout, if your apple knocks me out. So I would do it, and then I get the student to do it at home, and they can sing it, and they can find something that they can do it with. And then, of course, this is what we call the relative stave, because there is no treble clef or bass clef. I love the way I'm doing that there. There is no treble clef or bass clef there. So I can move it into a different place. You know, I could go, all the way up to here. 1, 2, 3, the fourth line. Let's take the pitch a bit higher as we've gone higher. Ooh, and this time in so far, I think. Off I go, so, so me, so, so me, so, so la, la, so, so me. A bit too high. So, so me, so, so me. So, so, la, la, so, so, me. And of course, doing something like this makes it very memorable indeed. So it's more likely to stick in the brain, especially if you return to it in a subsequent week. Just keep it a short activity. Don't do it for too long. And as I say, come back to it the following week, yeah, especially because it makes your arm ache. Come back to it the following week and reinforce it. And I love this idea, as I say, that we've got lines and the gaps between the notes. Actually, that seemed to make a lot more sense to my students. They all came out with that word, gaps. So there we go, hand stave on my lessons peasy. Have fun with that. Thanks for watching, everybody. I can see Anastasia's there. I can see Anne, Sophie. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good teach wherever you are in the world. Take care. Stay safe. See you next week. Bye-bye.